deep vein thrombosis causes, symptoms, and treatment. According to the Center for Disease Control, CDC, between 300,000 and 600,000 Americans experience deep vein thrombosis in any given year. Sometimes deep vein thrombosis can cause more serious conditions like heart attacks, strokes, or pulmonary embolism, blood clot in the lungs, but fatal complications are rare. Between 10 and 30% of people with deep vein thrombosis will die. What causes deep vein thrombosis? This condition develops as a result of conditions that cause blood clots to form. For example, after major surgery, patients are at risk to develop clots. Clots can form during long road trips or flights or as a result of specific medical conditions like heart arrhythmias. Some studies link oral contraceptives to an increased risk of blood clots, especially in women over 35. Other risk factors for blood clots include pregnancy, obesity, smoking, cancer, having a pacemaker, certain gastrointestinal disorders. Symptoms of deep vein thrombosis. About half of the time a person experiences deep vein thrombosis, no symptoms present. When symptoms do occur, they're generally in one leg. Keep in mind that deep vein thrombosis can occur in other areas of the body, but is most prevalent in the legs. When deep vein thrombosis happens, symptoms may include swelling in leg, ankle, and foot. Pain similar to muscle cramp or Charlie horse. Warm skin over affected spot. Skin that turns red, blue, or is extremely pale in comparison to other areas. If these symptoms present, contact your doctor right away. Diagnosing deep vein thrombosis. When you see your physician, he will ask you questions and conduct an exam. He will likely send you for additional testing to determine whether or not you have deep vein thrombosis. These tests may include ultrasound, blood tests, CAT scan or MRI, X-ray with contrast dye. While a deep vein thrombosis diagnosis is concerning, remember that most of the time it's easily dealt with. Treating deep vein thrombosis. Handling deep vein thrombosis effectively should result in keeping the clot from growing, keeping it from moving somewhere else in the body, and reducing chances of recurring deep vein thrombosis. There are several different treatment options for deep vein thrombosis. Your doctor will likely prescribe a blood-thinning drug to prevent the clot from getting any larger and a clot-busting drug to help break it down. When patients cannot take these medications, a filter inserted into the vena cava helps prevent clots from traveling to the lungs. Complications from deep vein thrombosis. The most common and most concerning complication from deep vein thrombosis is pulmonary embolism. When a clot lodges in the lungs, the results can be deadly. When deep vein thrombosis is present, it's imperative to watch for symptoms of pulmonary embolism, which are sudden shortness of breath, chest pain that gets more severe with deep breathing, dizziness, fainting, racing heartbeat, bloody cough. These symptoms require medical attention right away. Another complication from deep vein thrombosis known as postphlebitic or postthrombotic syndrome occurs when the veins affected by deep vein thrombosis become damaged, resulting in reduced blood flow to that area. Symptoms of this disorder may not present right away and sometimes don't show for years after the deep vein thrombosis event. Signs of postphlebitic syndrome are very similar to deep vein thrombosis and include swelling, pain, and skin changes. Preventing deep vein thrombosis. There are several steps you can take to lower your risk for developing deep vein thrombosis again. Take your medications as prescribed and stay in contact with your doctor. Consider alternate birth control if you're over 35. Monitor vitamin K intake, which can interfere with how well the blood thinning medications work. Exercise calf muscles often by moving around often. Working out, losing weight, and quitting smoking are all ways to reduce the risk of recurring deep vein thrombosis.